BlockShow, Singapore, here with Jason. Man, he has an app for what we are doing right now. Jason, please tell the Cointelegraph, BlockShow, and the DLive world who you are, what you do.
Yeah, well, thank you so much. Look, I've been at this for a long time. I've been building companies in this space for 20 plus years. The first app I worked on, first website I worked on, was AOL chat rooms back in 1998.
Wow.
Worked on several Web 2 companies. Mm-hmm. Always been trying to solve this kind of signal versus noise problem. How do you make more relevance? Mm-hmm. How do you also help creators, makers, to earn a living, to get their products in front of people? I started a company called fab.com, which was all about selling kind of designers' products directly to consumers and delighting people every day. The last 4 years of my life has been dedicated to blockchain, crypto, and trying to figure out how do we actually build products in crypto that people want to use.
Right.
So I'm a UX product designer. And the thing is, it's actually not that hard if you talk to people.
Right.
We talked to thousands of people over the last couple of years. We do interviews with people every single day to try to find out what people were craving, what they're missing, and where we can apply crypto towards that.
And so I can only imagine that you're on a plane every few hours, and you must have a wealth of knowledge after the past few years. And if you don't mind, have you realized that a lot of people have no idea how to take the blockchain and crypto and make it truly consumer facing?
Yeah, I think, look, there's so many amazing developers, makers in the crypto space who are building kind of the picks and shovels and tools to make user experiences possible.
Right.
And what our team has been doing, and there's increasingly more folks doing, is saying, well, let's come at this from both sides. Let's say there's folks who are building from the bottom up and building the infrastructure and the tools, and then there's others who are out there kind of talking to users, to consumers, trying to figure out how do we actually kind of build something that meets people's needs.
Right.
And the key thing is, like, so for the last couple of years, I feel like all too often, kind of crypto and blockchain has been kind of a solution looking for a problem to solve.
Huh.
And we flipped it on the head, right? Huh. And we kind of said, let's find interesting problems to solve with crypto.
Right.
And the way to do that, the only way to do it is to talk to people.
You gotta hit the ground.
Yeah.
You have to.
Yeah.
Take the meetings, hit the ground, schmooze, do everything.
And so what we did is we said, rather than trying to tackle the whole world to start, there's this movement in crypto. I mean, if you talk to people in crypto, you find out that they believe they're part of a movement. It's part about making society better.
Right.
It's about collaboration and openness rather than just competitiveness. And we talked to people and we said, well, how can we build something, a crypto app for the crypto community as a starting point?
Mm.
Kind of like how, say, Facebook started with Harvard and then went to college students, then to high school, then to the world.
Right.
We said, well, what if we were to start off by saying, don't try to tackle everything all at once, just build something the crypto community really needs.
Absolutely.
And by talking to crypto makers, developers, enthusiasts, we heard like this hunger, this need for authenticity.
Right.
Right. So we created an app that enables anyone who's making interesting things in crypto to create 30-second video updates on what they're working on, to present themselves to the community.
Mm.
It's all camera front facing, so it's not like the shilling and noise and nonsense you get in some other places.
Right.
And then we have the first fully embeddable cryptocurrency wallet in a mainstream application.
Mm.
We developed this over 4 years. It's an embeddable Ethereum wallet SDK. What it really just enables you to do is we turn the like button into a token transfer.
So hold on a second. So what most probably picked up on right now
is my energy?
That, and let's talk about what you just built.
Yeah.
So that don't just glance over that. You built a great video of consumer facing, but more for the industry.
Yeah.
Right? But then there was something that you built on top of that.
Yeah.
That can be replicated, can be white labeled, it can be spread across the thing. Now that's the interesting part about what you just said.
Yeah. So what we did is we built the industry's first fully embeddable Ethereum wallet SDK.
Okay.
And what the SDK means is a software developer kit that anyone can take. It's open source, and you can build this functionality into any application.
Right.
Right. And so what we did, for instance, in Pepo is you can basically, every like sends a token from one person to the other.
Who controls the tokenomics behind that?
Oh, it's on a blockchain, public blockchain.
Mm-hmm.
It's Ethereum layer 2. And so it's like, I encourage everyone, check it out, because
Okay.
You literally can start to say, all right, every upvote, every like, every five-star review, every time someone reads an article to completion, you can have them earn tokens, you can have them spend tokens, buy tokens.
Who's paying for that, reading the article all the way to the end?
You know, so it really depends on, you know, what the company that uses the technology wants to do.
Okay.
There's some folks that we're working with, for instance, who've taken our technology and they have like advertisers who are saying, you know, we'll be the sponsor and we'll pay for the tokens if people read the article and click on the ad.
Right.
Or if they interact with an element on the page. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We're working with a very large kind of multi-channel retailer. They have 94 locations, restaurants, bars. They sell food, beverage, and merchandise. And they're having, every time someone walks into their store and into the restaurants and interacts with the brand online, they're going to earn tokens, right? And then they're going to spend them with them and their partners. But that's like that dream that we've talked about for years. It's now starting.
We've been talking about this.
It's happening now.
Oh, and, that's fantastic. And so, wait, well, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
You didn't tell the people.
Yeah.
Pepo.
Yes. So notice that you can go to the App Store. So you go. So
no.
So it's the first crypto-powered app in the App Store, Apple and Google. Approved by Apple for in-app purchase. You can buy tokens in the app. You can buy crypto in the app. You can buy the Pepo coins in the app.
What is it called?
It's called Pepo, P-E-P-O.
Go ahead.
There you go. Try Pepo. It's the first crypto-powered app in the App Store, P-E-P-O. You don't need anything special to download it. You can get it in Google Play or Apple App Store. You can, within the app, we start you off with some tokens. You start off with 500 Pepo coins. You can use them every time you tap the like button. You basically send a token to the person whose content you like. You can send people tokens without having to write down 12 words or put in a clumsy address. Mm. You can, the tokens are used for personalization, for curation, for messaging people. And you can buy tokens in the app, and you can also cash out in the app. We have the first app, it's Apple approved, FinCEN regulatory approved, that you actually can buy currency and cash out for things like gift cards. So Amazon gift card, Airbnb gift card, here in Singapore a Grab gift card, all within the experience.
There's a reason for this silent pause right now, guys. It's not a glitch. This is the focus
it's real, right now.
Real.
And you know, the coolest thing is
very real.
There's a lot in blockchain that is like, you know, these promises the community's been making for years and years.
For years they've been hearing it.
It's real, right? And that's the best thing. And that's why, so people ask me, so we launched Pepo a month ago at DEF CON 5. Mm-hmm. It's the Ethereum annual developer conference. 25% of all people at the conference use the app.
Of course.
We're now up to, like, it's still beta, it's like 1,500 users. Mm-hmm. They've done 45,000 transactions, user to user, peer to peer, decentralized transactions on a blockchain in the last 30 days. It's a top 12 dApp in the world, the fastest growing in the world, and it's because we listen to users, that's all it is.
This is absolutely fantastic. If there's, I've asked a lot of people for advice over the past two days,
yeah.
And the resounding right statement is, listen to the consumer.
Yeah, look, the only way to build product, and I've been doing it for 20 plus years, is to find a pain point, find an actual need, and build to that need.
Right.
And you have to validate it every step of the way. It's talk to users to find out what they need, and then find out if what you build meets the need.
Right.
Where most projects go wrong, and not just crypto, around the whole world, like anything about building, most people, it's like entrepreneur, has a hunch, an hypothesis, that this is the problem, that, you know, the solution to a problem, but they don't talk to anyone.
Okay.
So they spend, you know, 6 months a year building something, they launch it in the market, and no one uses it because you didn't talk to people. The whole trick to this is you've got to do, you know, user interviews, find pain points, build to the pain, mm-hmm. find where people are getting stuck, help them get unstuck, and then keep that conversation dialogue going until you kind of hit that, everyone is pulling the app from you, they want it so bad.
Right. Let me ask you, how many people are on your team right now?
Yeah, so we're about 55 people.
Fantastic.
We've been working on this since 2016. Mm. And for the most part, for the last 4 years, we're just heads down building all the technology.
Say, yeah, you guys were heads down all the time.
We were kind of saying, look, there's so much noise out there.
Right.
I mean, crypto can be a circus, right? There's a whole lot of nonsense out there. And I said to our team, look, you know, we raised equity financing in 2016. We have amazing investors, VC investors, big corporate investors. And we said, just keep your head down and build.
Right.
Because when it's time to shout, it'll be when you have something to show people.
Right.
So last month at DEF CON, we started to show people Pepo.
Mm-hmm.
And the amazing thing is they like it, right?
Yeah.
And they say, okay, now we'll start to talk about it.
Right. Well, it makes sense. I'm sorry. I think you fit a need. You fill that need.
Hopefully so. Hopefully so. Look, everything, it's... We take it with a grain of salt. We feel like the early users really, really enjoyed the app. The usage is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
We talk to them. They are telling us what they want us to build next. We're going to build those features next.
Good.
And we don't ask them what feature you want. We ask you, what are you trying to accomplish? So we have people in the app. The number one use case in the app right now is it's basically people are trying to launch products or showcase their projects.
Right.
And so how do we help them do that better?
Right.
And then they say, well, how do we help the community of people that are kind of supporting the project? How do we help them get involved?
Mm.
So that's what we're looking at right now, is how do we help projects launch, promote themselves in an authentic way, mm-hmm. and have their whole army of community support that within the app. Wow. That's what we're working on right now.
How many developers do you have under the umbrella?
All right, so like 55 people on our team, like myself included, because I'm a product, you know, product designer, about 45 of us are working on product.
It makes sense. That's what the world is when we sit down right now.
Look, until 4 months ago, we didn't build really anything front-end facing. It was all just building picks and shovels, tools, infrastructure. Wow. 4 months ago, we looked and said, well, now let's show the world it's possible with technology.
Right.
And then we built this app on top of it.
By the way, congratulations.
Thank you.
I've heard, you know, as you know, we've all been in this quite some time. I've heard a lot of promises.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of unfulfilled promises.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of projects fall short.
Yeah.
And it is fantastic
yeah.
to hear that you've actually built something,
it's
delivered, and I've seen the product, I know exactly what it is.
Yeah.
From my only problem right now is the problem that you have.
What's that?
Is it Pepo or Pepo?
Oh, it's Pepo, man.
I know.
It's Pepo.
I know.
It's got a pep to it. It's got.
Are saying Pepo.
That's okay.
It's the Pepo.
That's okay. You know what? Listen to your users, right? I talked to people, and I found that the American English language is the only language that has a hard E, right? So everyone else in the world, no matter what we call it, are going to call it Pepo.
No matter what.
No matter what.
This is what you get from listening to your consumers.
Yep. Yep.
This is what you, and then now you get the American advantage, which is don't listen to anyone
else.
I'll
tell you this also, like, you know, everyone's like always like, you know, on ramps, off ramps. Well, we talked to users and we said, so if you earned $100 or $200 worth of appreciation in the app, what would you need in terms of like cashing out, right? And we gave them options, like would you want to cash out to Bitcoin, to Ethereum, to your bank account, to an Amazon gift card or an Airbnb gift card or credit. And I mean, then we showed them like the difficulty of each one, and resoundingly everyone told us that Amazon gift card is just the same as cash if it was like a one click, and that's what we went with. So it's like, you don't have to solve like the theoretical problem, solve the real problem.
I like the way the architecture went around. I like the way that you guys went around. It was smart.
Thank you.
Obviously, loyalty and rewards plays a huge point in the architecture. That's my background, so I get that completely. And you guys have successfully done that, and I'm kind of proud of you guys
on
this right
now. We're off to a good start, and as long as we keep talking to users, we can make something that's really,
well,
really
let's
valuable.
Keep talking to users, and let me know what the community can do for you.
Awesome.
And you have the community right there. Ask them what you would like them to engage in.
Check out Pepo. It's easy to download. You can be using the app within 30 seconds of the download. You don't need to write down 12 words to secure a wallet, a 6-digit PIN, smart recovery from a smart contract. You can be sending some tokens in a matter of seconds by clicking on the like button. Try that, and then give us feedback, because we want to build an app that works for you.
All right. DLive, we'll be right back. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate you so much, man. That was really good.
Thank you. Really appreciate it. Awesome.